Good news, everyone. Today we're gonna do a video that you guys have been asking for quite a while, and it revolves around this. Do you remember this? This is the tower cooler that I 3D printed on the FDM printer to see if it worked, and it surprisingly did pretty well. And since that video, a lot of you guys have been like, why don't you go about making a new one that's a little more, you know, better. And I was like, you know what, okay. So that's the idea today. If you don't remember this project, essentially this was the bottom that let air in that mounted to the top of a reservoir, like a soul. And the top part simply set into that Colosseum looking thing. And this was filled with these discs. And these plastic discs acted as infill, and they essentially just broke the water up as it passed down the cooling tower to increase its surface area and promote evaporation. And it worked pretty well, at least at this scale. And to, oop, broken. Oh no, there's a spray nozzles inside there. But anyway, this worked, and today I want to try to make it look better. I'm gonna hesitate to say better. More, see, obviously, if you look at this, you know that this is a hack a job. And you're never gonna find something like this for sale anywhere. So the idea today is to shrink it down and make it look like something that you could possibly buy. I don't know why you would, but that's beside the point. Now, all the parts that we're going to look at were printed on the Beniform Mono from Nova 3D, and I have been loving this little resin 3D printer. For one, the build volume is slightly bigger than a lot of resin printers you'll see in the market. Also, this lid, I don't know why I like this so much, but the fact that it's hinged and has a backrest to make it just stay out of your way when you're printing, I'm a big fan, especially compared to like the Mars that I'm used to, where you have to take the plastic lid off and then you gotta find a place to put it. I love that I can just get this out of the way, get my prints, and just move along. Also, the fact that this uses a linear rail on the Z-axis is awesome in my opinion. It really helps constrain the Z-axis more so you don't get any shifting layers, and everything just feels more rigid. The only problem is, if you're not careful and you're a bit of a noob like myself, I happened to leave some cured resin on the bottom of the tank one time, and when I hit print, well, because it's such a rigid system, there's one thing that had to give, and in my case, it was the screen, and I broke the screen during all this printing that I was doing on this resin printer for this project, which is what slowed it down a little bit for release. But I will say that ordering the screen was pretty simple. I just picked one on Amazon. It was here in a few days. Putting it in was quite simple. The ribbon cable was a little finicky, but what are you gonna do about that? And it was back up and running. That was literally the only issue I had with it. Other than that, the fact that it's a mono printer, or has a mono screen on it, it really does actually improve the print speed when compared to, like, when I was comparing to the Mars that I have that just has a regular LCD. The mono is way quicker to print, and just a lot better of a experience all around. Connectivity is pretty awesome in this printer too. You get an RJ45 jack in the back, USB as well. And then actually this thing has Wi-Fi. Now, I didn't actually hook it up to the Wi-Fi, but it's awesome that it has that little function for you to use if you want to. Literally the only thing I didn't like about the Nova 3D, well, not even really the printer, it was just the software that Nova 3D uses. They have a Nova Maker, and I hate it. I feel like it just feels clunky, especially to somebody that's pretty new to resin printing. Putting supports down, the auto generation absolutely sucks, which I'm trying to get away from doing auto generating supports, trying to do it more manually, but still. So I was kind of using ChichuBox to kind of put my supports down and then saving it out as an STL file, putting it into the Nova Maker to slice, because I found that the add-on to print, I think it's CWS files for the Beniform Mono in ChichuBox was hit or miss. Sometimes it would work and sometimes it would fail. But all in all, for a nice little resin printer with a slightly larger build area than what you're normally gonna see, the Beniform Mono, solid pick. I'll leave you a link down below if it's something you wanna get into. Resin printing is actually pretty awesome. It's a little messy, but after you kind of start figuring out, the things you can do with it are awesome. So the first thing we'll look at is this this reservoir. Pretty standard. Literally the reservoir that comes off of the D5 pump from EK. Not much to it. The only difference we're gonna make is that this time around, I want it to be taller, and since I don't have, you know, the taller version, I only have this other small version. We're going to use this ring and this O-ring that I stole from one of their lids to bolt them together to give us a taller column of water. And the idea behind that is I'm hoping that with a taller column of water, we can settle those bubbles down and not, you know, pump them back to the system. So we'll see if that works. Hopefully it doesn't leak everywhere. Should be good. So So on top of the reservoirs, we need a way to get, you know, air into the system so everything evaporates and cools, and that's where this little breather comes in. It's just a space with holes in it, really. Along the top, I actually added a little bit of a lip to hopefully, you know, guide the water down into the middle of the reservoir and not, you know, let it splash out of the sides. And then I tested it and it didn't work, so I had to revise that design to this one. Same thing, just I added this cup around the outside and it does a good job. So there's the air inlet, the breather, if you will. And then we got probably the most important part. This is the infill, and to design this, I just copied the reservoir. I changed the threads from male to male to female, and down the middle, I added these slats to break up the water as it's falling down. And there's 8 of them. They're 90 degrees opposed, and they actually printed out pretty darn good. I literally printed this as one piece, no supports. And it worked really good. I'm hoping it works as well as it looks. I printed it in clear resin because I want it to be transparent, kind of like the reservoir. And you can see how well that worked out. Transparent resin isn't really as transparent as I wanted it to be. And if you cure it too long, it turns quite yellow. Then on top, we need a way to drive air through the system because it's not going to be tall enough to, you know, make a natural draft. So this is where the power head that I made, and also I made all these names up. But essentially what we got here is another spacer similar to the breather that goes on top of the infill that we're going to mount fans to. And the fans we're gonna use are these A4x20s or A420s from Noctua. And we're gonna mount 5 of them around the rim of this to pull air out of the system and hopefully cool it. I don't know. It's a pretty small little system here. Yes, it's so beautiful. So this is the lid. This is just a lid from one of the reservoirs. And I have a ball valve on it, and we're gonna limit the flow. Remember last time, when you let the pump run full out, it's just gonna foam up and sadness ensues. So this will help us limit the flow. I could limit the flow on the pump. It is a PWM pump, but you know, I have this ball valve, so I'm gonna use that. Now we just need to take the radiator off, hook it up, and see if we can't done cool something. God, this is beautiful. Let me screw this on here real quick. Okay, so I think we're good. Out goes into our inlet. This comes out of the CPU block into the top of the thing. And check. We'll worry about the fans here shortly, but where's our water? Let's do some filling it up. Let's get our flow set how we want. We can turn on our system. Here she goes. Oh boy. She's working. So far, so good. I'm actually surprised this is not actually leaking down here. Our custom super tall radiator. Now, the real question is since we gotta choke down the flow here, are we gonna have enough flow to keep the CPU cool? Couldn't tell you. So we've been running for a minute here, just letting it run. Good news, there's no leaking yet. That's awesome. So I guess we'll see what our temperature's like. This actually looks really, it's like a soothing waterfall. It could add a nice ambiance to your gaming system. The only concern I guess I really have is that we're using these really small fans. Yeah, we're using 5 of them, but are they gonna have enough power to bring the air up through the infill? That is the question. You know what we can do? smoke test to see if there's actually air getting drawn in from the bottom. Why not? Why not use a smoke machine? We are actually drawing air into the system. It's not really, you wouldn't call it like a hurricane or gale force winds, but it's working, I guess. It's not leaking though. That's the number one thing. So we're just gonna see if it can actually cool the system. Also, we got my thermometer here. Humidity's kind of high today, 57%, which might hurt us. Temperature wise, 19.1 in the room today. Let's just give her a start and see what happens. It's been a little over 45 minutes and there is some good news. The good news is, the system is not throttling. That's really it. The bad news is we're starting to leak a little bit. So as the system's warmed up, my seal is not as good as I thought it was. And we're not throttling, but our temperatures aren't that good. Temperatures average 88.1. And we had a maximum of 100 at a certain point. Room temperature is 19.2. So yeah, we're not doing too good. But we only have one little infill piece here. So I wonder if we can do better if we add more. Because I have three more. And we're going to try to put them on there and see if that can give us better temps. It's going to get quite tall and even more ridiculous, but hey, let's do it. Oh my gosh. Yeah, it's not even on the screen. I'm gonna back that up. Ta-da! There you go. That is, how tall is that? Oh, it's almost exactly 3 feet tall. Or yeah, about 915 millimeters. But that's pretty tall. So the whole idea of making it less ridiculous is kind of out the window. With one infill and like the top, yeah, you could maybe package that into something. I don't know why you would, because one, it evaporates water. This one leaks too, so you have to constantly put more water in it. Also, you'd eventually pick up dust and whatnot. But when it gets to this size, that ridiculousness gets to a new level. But anyway, let's see if it does better. Yeah, so it's been about, what, 36, 37 minutes, and temperatures, ignore the little bump there where I was messing around, but temperatures aren't doing any better. Actually, they're doing slightly worse, or 88.7 now. Room temperature is 19.4. The humidity, 58, so the humidity's gone up a little bit in the room. It's still 58%. If we had, based on what we did, or what we know from last time we did this, I think if we had a little bit lower humidity in the room, we'd see better temperatures. Also, I think the fans at the top are what's holding us back. We're just not pulling enough air through the infill column to evaporate enough water to drop our temperatures. But either way, we'll call it successful, because we did make, I mean, not in its current form. This is a bit ridiculous. But when it was like just one infill high, It was a reasonable little setup. I mean, you wouldn't want to do it full time. I mean, you could, I guess, but I don't know why you would. But it was doable, and it did keep the system cool. There could be some improvements in our water tightness, but other than that, it was a lot of fun to try. I'm glad we got another shot at it with this resin printer. And the possibilities with resin printing are limitless. So if you have an idea for a video you want to see, Let me know down below. We can design anything. If you can think it up, I can make it for you. Till next time. Peace.